Hey, what's going on? My name is George, and I'm going to show you how to get started with a brand new profile on Wayward Terran Frontier Alpha Version 3. Yes, I deleted my save just so that I could make this video. I want to show kind of the new stuff from the perspective of someone who has just installed the patch. You start off with only 5,000 budget, and the hope is that I can kind of show you the gameplay of how to unlock things to people who've played the previous versions, and then also at the same time I'll be showing off kind of what the gameplay of this game is meant to be to people who've never heard of it before. As you can see, I've got two ships here. This one I've actually made prior to making this video. You start with a starter ship. And I have a ship designer. This is like the editor for your ship. On the right, I've got the modules I can place. On the left, I've got different categories of different types of modules. You can see how much budget I have total and how much my ship currently costs, as well as inertia is a measure of kind of how massive your ship is. And so you have to have these structure modules. So you can see these are structure modules that I've placed down. These orange stuff is structure. And every structure module increases your integrity. And ships which don't have enough structural support to hold them together will break apart. I'll show you that stuff later. But this is the ship you start off with, and I'll talk more about kind of what the different components do as I play through the game. As you see, I've actually got enough money. I could kind of expand my ship here a bit, but I don't really have any space, and that's why, actually, I ended up designing this other ship hull, because it uses more of my budget, but I'll get into that later, and I'll show you the process of designing a ship. But for now, I'm going to just spend that extra budget on one other crew member. Yeah, two other crew members. No, okay, one other crew member. So I'm going to jump right into Galactic Conquest mode. It's a mode where you are just kind of dumped into a universe, and as you travel to different places, the people at those places try to attack and kill you. And you get money for killing them, and, let's just get into it. So, the guy in the gold shirt is me. The guy in the red shirt is fully expendable. I'm going to use him to repair things while I fly around and shoot, well, this thing, actually, it's shooting me. I took too long. The first enemy is already after me. I'm going to just kind of shoot him here. I think if I shoot his gun off, he'll... Yeah, he can't do anything now, so he's kind of given up. And what you notice is that... I happen to know that that's his little command pod. Yeah, there, I shot him. So, you get money for killing the crew members on the ships that you're fighting. You don't get money for killing the ships themselves, since the ships are just... Well, as you can see, there's no discrete thing that defines what a ship is and isn't. And so now that I've defeated him, I've defeated the wave for this sector. So I'm going to go to my map, and so this is the area that I'm in right now. It looks like if I go off to the right, there's an asteroid field, so there should be more bad guys there. So I'm going to kind of point to the right, and I'm going to activate travel drive. I'm pushing T here. Oh, and to get to the map is M. I really intend to have buttons for these things someday, but I'm just one guy developing this, and I didn't get around to it. Maybe it'll be in the next patch. In fact, yes, it's going to be in the next patch. I just have to get around to it. Maybe this afternoon. So here I've flown into the asteroid, and I'm disabling travel drive before I overshoot him. And I think it's going to be the same guy I just fought before. He's kind of the wussy guy, designed to be easy to defeat. But things get a lot harder as you get farther on. Oh, well, I got him. He didn't explode, but I got him. Whatever. I'm thinking I'll go up. Did I take any damage? Any significant damage? No, I didn't take any significant damage. Oh, good! And my first loot ship is going to give me budget. Oh! Unless I fly past it. So, there's two little fighters. Apparently I have to fight two this time. And that guy over there has got some loot. I'll show you how the looting works after I defeat these. And maybe I'll be kind and edit out this really long segment of me shooting these two guys. Or maybe I won't. No promises. Explode! Ah, thank you. You have to... They explode if their reactor is damaged to the point of breaking. So, as you saw before, I just shot the crew members. I shoot the little crew cabin before, so I actually killed the crew without really destroying the reactor. This guy, I've hit his structure now, so he's, like, kind of shredding. That's what happens when you don't have enough structure, or if your structure gets destroyed. Every time you take damage from normal attacks, your ship kind of shreds a little bit, so, like, holes open up all over, and the ship falls apart. So now this is where all the loot comes from in the game. Right now he doesn't do much, because initially I made him do interesting things, like run away from you, and I found that to be really irritating, because all I wanted to do was collect the loot. So he'll probably be changed in the future to be a little bit more interesting, but right now there's one crew member in there which won't let you dock, so if you shoot him enough, all of his atmosphere vents out and he dies pretty easily. And then, as you see here, I'm pushing shift, and that turns on docking mode. And now, I showed you I have an airlock. The airlock allows you to dock to other ships. And so the way I'm going to do that is I'm going to kind of come up here, and I can either click the button, or I can push the X key. And that'll start transferring the cargo. This one's going to give me money, so let's see how much. Okay, it looks like I got about 1,000 money. So already I've got enough to probably make a much better ship. Now I can either push Z or click this button to undock. I'm going to push Z, undock from that ship, turn off dock mode, and go to the next section. And fight one more wave of guys, and then I'll show you the ship editor. Took me extra long to kill that guy because he took out one of my guns, and I wasn't able to repair it because it's too far away. So I guess it goes to show you it's worth designing a ship where you can actually repair the parts. So I'm going to show you, before I go design another ship, I want to show you the types of things that spawn if you go to really far away areas, like over there, for instance. And so I'm gonna travel really, really fast if I can. Okay. I think we're well on our way. It's gonna take me a little while to travel, so I'm gonna pause the video. Again. Alright. Here you can see, so I've built up actually quite a lot of speed, as you can see, while traveling through that distance. There's no speed limit in travel mode, so if you keep accelerating in a direction, eventually you'll go insanely fast. And I'm going to zoom in here because I'm about to enter an asteroid field. This... Whoa! Overshot them a bit. As you can see now, I've spawned more than one or two bad guys. This zone should be way beyond my difficulty level, and I expect they're going to blow me up quite quickly. But I just wanted to show you that as you go farther... you get, well, A, that budget boost should have more money, and these ships, you know what, out of curiosity, let's see if I can steal the budget boost before these guys kill me. Okay, so that's a little wussy guy. That's easy enough. I'm gonna try to avoid all of these little wussy enemies and see if I can get straight to the money, because if I can collect the money before these guys kill me... I don't really think those three guys are going to kill me. What I think is going to kill me is either that guy, or... Oh! It's just a whole bunch of small ships. Yeah, that happens sometimes. Still, I'm not going to be able to take... What is that, five of them? and especially with one of my guns taken out, that'll take way too long. I took the liberty of, while I was flying to this sector, I had my little crew member guy repair some of the armor, but he's, like I said, he couldn't reach the gun, so I still only have one wussy gun. Sometimes a ship will spawn that will repair everything on your ship to full, and if it had been one of those, I might be able to fight these guys. But as it stands, let's just try and... Oh! You know what? Friendly fire is on, so if I hide, they can't get me. Come on. I can do it! Yes! I got it. Oops. That shouldn't have happened like that. Yeah, my last gun is out. Repair it! Repair it, little guy! Oh, all my engines are gone. And now I've got holes in my ship. Well, that's gonna be my first playthrough. I think maybe I will just accept the inevitability of defeat. There we go. And that's how that ended. So, I take the budget that I earned, and I am going to... So there's my ship. I don't think there's anything I can do to improve this ship, so I'm going to make a new profile. And I'm going to use this one. We'll name it Rust, because that's what this ship looks like. Okay, now I got a lot more space, and, ooh, I have 10,000 budget. I can make something pretty interesting with this. So, what am I going to start with? Well, the thing I know for certain is that I want to have a bigger gun, because it was really irritating to fight those guys with that tiny little gun. And I think I'd like to actually try to have two bigger guns. Okay, let's remove that. I think I can do two bigger guns in this. So I'm going to place them kind of stratified here because these things are tracks that the turrets rotate on, and I want my guns to be able to rotate in 360 degrees, so I need to have these things. Now the position that I'm putting these in is... predetermined. Like, you can't put them in places other than where I'm putting them right now. They won't work anywhere else, which I think is kind of a big point of irritation for a lot of people trying to design a ship for the first time. I'm trying to show right now exactly where you can put them. I've also written on my website, you know, some pictorial guides as to demonstrate where you can put them, but I think overall what I need is a new UI element that really just shows you where they can go. And I've already started working on that, but the problem is it's a trick to get the... Anyways, it's a problem I'm working on solving, and probably won't be in the next patch, but... you know, because the next patch has to be that button I talked about. So, two guns. I'm going to need a reactor, obviously. Let's, well, put it in the space back here, because it has to have injectors. And, ooh, can I afford three? I think I can afford three. So, three injectors. This is going to be a good ship. A reactor generates heat every time it generates energy, and if it overheats, it stops working. So these are radiators. And I'm going to put about three of them for each injector that I have, with one extra. And then I've forgotten the most important thing, which is structure. I told you, so I've got a lot more inertia here now because I'm a bigger ship, so I'm going to try to see if I can fit one of these really large structure modules. Oh, why won't you fit? You look like you should fit. Oh, you're preventing me from fitting. There we go. Okay. That, and then some of the smaller structure modules can just go here. If I put it like this, then it'll work as a wall to prevent all of my atmosphere from flying out of my ship. That'll be nice. Okay, that's plenty of structure. I like having a little bit of extra structure, because then when parts of the ship get shot, like this, if this whole structure module gets broken, then my ship is just tanked. It doesn't have any more structure, and it'll start falling apart. So you can kind of be strategic in how you design your ship, like putting the structure on the inside or whatever. That's up to you. I'm not really thinking too much about it for this design, because I'm more concerned about working within this budget of 10,000. I happen to know that the ships I'm going to be fighting, as you saw, are going to be pretty wussy, so having these two big guns is going to be great. These are capacitors. They store energy. That's pretty much all they do. They're cheap. They're simple. And they have these connectors over in the corners here. I want this ship to be easy to repair, so I'm going to put these conduits, because it allows me to walk over them. I have to figure out where I'm going to put my crew members. Probably put them in here, but wherever I put my crew, in order to repair things, they're going to need to be able to get to those things. And then let's also wire up this gun over here. So now both of my guns are wired. I'm going to need to turn, so I'll put some thrusters. Have to be touching the edge of the ship. And of course, I've forgotten engines, which are usually important for a ship to move. And it occurs to me now that the big engine won't fit because of where I chose to put my reactor. So let's just make a really slow ship. This is not going to be ideal, but who cares? Can I fit any more? Yeah, that'll fit. There we go. Like I said, I'll put my crew members here. So, well, let's just get around to, before we wire those up, this is a console, as you've seen in the past. Do I want to fire my own guns? I think I want to fire my... let's see if I can have the crew fire my guns for me. So, I'm going to make a second console. I'll put it there. And then you've got these little connector thingies. So I put N next to that console, because that's the navigation console. This console, when you use it, you will fly the ship. You can turn the ship and shoot any guns. So if I were to put N there, now I would fire the guns while flying the ship. But since these rotate 360, I want to put the AI in charge of flying them. So I'm going to create another group. I'm going to create group 1 and put group 1 there. It can be anywhere. So long as it's just touching it. But keep in mind, if it's touching both like that, it might make this a group 1, depending on where you put it. Because a console can only be in one group. So if I put these, now those guns are both in group 1. And they will fire. I think I've cut myself off from the rest of the ship by placing this engine, so I'm going to remove it. Actually, instead, I'm going to go back to my engine here, and I put it there, because I need two spaces for the crew to walk through. I have some more engines, more conduits, and I think that that's probably enough engines that this one conduit won't have enough power output. Conduits have a finite amount of energy that they can transfer each, you know, update or whatever. So I'm going to put capacitors down here so that energy that comes out of the reactor will fill up these capacitors, and when I use the engines, it'll drain from the capacitors instead of draining directly from the reactor. That means that if I'm doing full thrust, like, I won't have my engines cutting out on me. And then, finally, I'm going to need this, which is life support. I'll just put it here. Probably be a good idea to have two of them, because I'm going to have more than one crew member. Let's go for three. Then, what else? Oh, an airlock. It's important to have an airlock, because if you don't have an airlock, you can't board other ships and collect loot. So, I'll put it there. And then, I wanted two. Can I do three crew members? Oh, I better do two, because I need the rest of the money for walls. So, this is armor. I'm gonna just kinda cover the outside of my ship in this, because when I take damage, when armor gets hit, it takes a lot less damage, and when the edge of my ship gets hit, if it doesn't have a wall, it'll vent the atmosphere. And so by putting a wall, I'm kind of protecting myself from being vented out into space. If I run out of money, which I might run out of budget, I can... Oh, I guess I need to connect these. I might run out of budget here, and that's okay if I do. If I run out of budget, then I'll just kind of make a habitable section just for my crew member. In fact, yeah, let's do that. Let's just kind of make a wall here. So now you can kind of see, I should be able to kind of reach most areas of the ship to repair them, but really there are some areas that I'm just not going to be able to reach, and that's fine. Maybe put some in here, kind of get a lucky shot in there that could vent my whole atmosphere. Okay, where else? Okay, I think that's good enough. And then, oh, this'll not do. I need much more radiators. If you have too few radiators, your reactor will overheat, and then it stops producing energy, and then you have to wait for it to cool down before it'll have more energy. Here, that's what this is for. I can put radiators here. Radiators have to connect to energy, but they don't have to use energy, so I don't really care about the... I don't care about the conduit capacity. The difference between that conduit and this conduit is that this conduit will block air movement, so I can use it as a wall. Likewise, I'm going to do that here in case they hit this corner. And this might as well be a wall because it's cheaper. And then I need my thrusters to work. There. That should be a semi-working ship. And, oh, I'm so close to being over my budget, but I'm not, which is perfect. So now, let's see if it'll let me go. Yes, it did. Cool. So I'm in my ship. So you go command that turret. I left-clicked to command him to... So he's now controlling these two turrets. If I go... Here's my ship. I can turn. I can move. And my gunner will shoot enemies for me. Psh. Man, I almost don't have to do anything. Yeah, nice shooting there. Wow, see, this is much more convenient. And he explodes very nicely. Ah, good, the ship's still fast enough to not be irritating when I travel between zones. And you can see, kind of I'll continue on from there. I don't think this video is going to be long enough for me to show you unlocking any of the really cool loot, because it depends on... Oh, I went to the stupid distance. Whatever. As you can see, the universe is very large, so you're never going to run out of places to go. I went to just here, and I found some pretty difficult guys, but, well, actually I found five wussy guys, but I guarantee you that if you get far enough away, it should get pretty much undefeatable. But by going farther out there, you get better and better loot, so there's all sorts of stuff to unlock. And by all sorts of stuff, I mean there's a little bit of stuff to unlock, and I'm working really, really hard to add more now that I've got that system in place. Hopefully I covered everything, and that's Wayward Terran Frontier. You can download it on my website, www.wtfrontier.com. There's an open alpha button in the top right. That should give you this version to play around with, and now that it's out, it's probably going to be about all of 15 minutes before someone finds a bug, and I'm going to have to upload new versions, new content, and new bug fixes all the time, so keep an eye out for that. And thanks for watching, and talk to you later.